I've had someone come up to you and say, yeah, right, rocks have energy. Whatever. And, no? Never? Okay, just me. Just me. So, tonight I'm presenting all about energy and frequency, and it's got nothing to do with rocks, and it's got everything to do with the intention that's behind it. So I'll cover what my agenda is first, and while people settle in so they can see what I'm going to talk about. Now, there's one item at the bottom, and I left it off so you don't see it. It's right down here. I can read it, but you can't read it. And it's about chakras. And I might pronounce it a little bit different, and don't worry. You might say chakra, and that's cool too. And you might say, that's a bad word in my book, and that's okay too. But hopefully at the end of it, I'm able to tie in different cultures and religions around the world, including Christianity, where we talk about energy and the sevenness. And I talk about the seven main chakras, and Laurel talked about other chakras, and I'll cover some of them as well, of the seven main ones, and the crystals associated with it as well. We're going to talk a little bit about the three different types of rocks, and you can see them in red. In case you forget grade 9 geology, there it is all right there. Igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. Does anyone remember this at all? No idea. Good. Me neither. So I had to go back and take a look again. Igneous rocks, ignition, ignite, volcanoes. Good. So extrusive igneous rocks, pretty easy, right? Outside of the volcano, intrusive igneous rocks inside of the volcano. All right. Outside of the volcano, rocks cool very quickly. Crystal formation is very small. Is anyone familiar with obsidian from Mexico or something like that? Obsidian in Mexico has many ancient volcanoes, and you have that black volcanic glass. Well, that is not a single crystal, but millions of crystals made up into one rock. Millions of single crystals, but you can't see them unless you have a microscope to see each individual crystal. Further look at the atomic structure of it. Now, if we looked at the atomic structure, it kind of looks like this. But if you turn this diagram, you turn it on its axis and look through this point to that corner. So from this corner to that corner. So you see this is one side of the cubic shape, and that's another side. So if I look in from corner to corner, there's the line up here. Now, how many sides to a quartz crystal? 26. Wow, that's amazing that the atom is the same as what it looks like in real life. Now, obviously, there's what's called a crystal lattice or silicon lattice, where they start stacking on top of each other, and then you have crystal growth that looks like the picture on the right-hand side. Well, someone's going to say, well, no, wait a second, there's only 13 here. What's going on? I thought there was 14. Remember, we're looking through from corner to corner, so one is over, this is two here. There's one here, and then there's one at the back corner. If you look at it three-dimensionally. And this works out with every element of the periodic table. If you take any element of the periodic table and flatten it and lay it flat and turn it in a certain orientation, you will get a sacred geometry shape like this. And we wonder why certain things are attracted to other things. Now, so how are we connected with this frequency or vibration? Does anyone know I said it last year, does anyone know the exact frequency of quartz? Do you remember in the 70s? Now, I'm born in 71. My grandfather, he was Italian, and you know everything was ego with him, and he had this, you know, he had a fur coat. He was the typical mafioso style, not that type of Italian, but he played the cards and the poker, and he'd come home, oh, I got this new watch, Charles. It's got quartz movement. That was a big thing in the 70s. Ooh, you got a good watch that you didn't have to wind. Remember that? We went from winding watches to quartz movement. Quartz has a steady frequency of 32,768 hertz. Right? It's a very stable frequency. We're able to measure time with it. So, now, looking at this diagram, who has ever done yoga before? And you chant the word Om. Right? When you chant the word Om, this is the vibration. This is what shows up. Now, believe me when I say, who's been to a science center? When they were like 5 years old, you went to a science center? I'm sure in Toronto, where I live, near Toronto, there's this big speaker with a plate of glass on top with sand on it, and you dial the tone on the speaker. And what happens with the sand? It dances around into sacred geometry or shapes. The frequency creates vibration. The words of love or Om or Amen or Allah or God or Jesus or Krishna or Shiva or any name you choose creates a vibration of frequency that you can't see, but it's felt throughout. Every time we chanted Reiki or love here, the Lake George got it. All right, everyone, the hunters, they put their guns down.